Hi, this is Sandy Nighthaven, and welcome back to my channel, Running Wild. Today, I want to talk about some things you absolutely have to do to be healthy if you're going plant-based or you already are plant-based. And again, these couple of things are optimal for performance and just your own health. And the first thing is B12. Now, if you watch the movie The Game Changers, this was touched on a little bit, but I can't emphasize enough how important this is. B12, it helps maintain a healthy nervous system and the formation of red blood cells. So super important. And if you start getting low, there are serious consequences to your health. And there's even some studies that say, oh, being vegan or vegetarian isn't that healthy. And those studies are back from like the 80s or 90s when people didn't know to take B12. And basically all the studies showed is that you really need to take B12 to be like as healthy as you can be on a vegetarian, vegan, plant-based diet. So B12 is produced by bacteria, and humans used to get it from either like natural water sources or just having a little bit of dirt on our food. But because we live in such a sanitized world, that's not possible anymore. The interesting thing about B12 is what research has found is that we actually absorb it better from the synthetic B12, and that's why the USDA actually recommends taking synthetic B12 over just eating animals. And that's also why a lot of meat eaters also suffer from B12 deficiencies. And a lot of animals who are used for food are actually have feed that is supplemented with B12 in it. Let me think, what else about B12? So the recommendation for B12 is that you take about 2,500 micrograms per week. And just to let you know about how many pills you're taking per week, one of my supplements, it's about 1,000 micrograms, and so I have to take, well, it rounds out to be 2.5 pills per week, so I normally just take 3 and play it safe. It's a little bit harder to overdose on B12, so don't worry about that so much. And let me think. I think that's it for B12. But again, I cannot stress enough how important it is that you start taking B12 regularly. And again, synthetics tend to be better anyway. It's a good thing to keep track of, get blood tests, see where you're at, and then just start making sure you take that regularly. So this brings me to the second tip, and all it is to make sure you're eating enough. Now this sounds really simple, but it's actually something you have to think about as you're transitioning to a plant-based diet. And that's because animal products are typically pretty calorie dense, and then you look at like fruits and veggies and even like whole grains like rice, they're a lot less calorie dense than your typical animal products. And so so if you're an athlete, especially if you're already pretty lean, you have to think about increasing the volume of food you eat or just adding in more calorie dense food. So maybe more nuts, seeds, avocados, maybe in drinking some plant-based milk, or just incorporating more like whole grain breads versus whole grain rice and just stuff like that. Some of the reasons why you hear people go vegan or vegetarian and then a few weeks later say like, oh, I really didn't feel good. And a lot of times you hear people who are transitioning say like, oh, I'm just really craving meat or eggs right now. And that could actually, like when I've just question people a little bit more, we actually find out is they're actually just craving more calorie dense foods. So that's really something to think about. Again, you're either increasing the volume of food you eat or incorporating more calorie dense foods. And you could even compare your diets, just track your calories on your typical diet now to a typical more like what you plan to be eating plant-based diet, just to compare and make sure you're getting enough calories. Again, you have to make sure you fuel enough as an athlete. So getting the right nutrient dense calories in is an absolute must to feel good. So those are my two tips. Really, please, please don't skip B12 and make sure you're eating enough. And I think those are really the two most important things. If you have questions, feel free to leave them below. I will be taking eCornell's plant-based nutrition course for the second time. So if you follow me on social media, I'll be offering more plant-based tips to help you transition to a plant-based diet. So with that said, thank you so much for watching. Truly appreciate it. If you like this, please subscribe. And until next time, keep running wild.